Hi, my name's Shorful, and welcome to another one of my videos where I talk about the real world of data. So I've been in the data space for about over 20 years now, originally starting off as like a researcher and then moving into sort of being an analyst, and then obviously having some senior positions within some companies, running data functions. And then in the last few years, I've been doing my own thing, running my own analytics consultancy. And one of the things that people who are thinking about becoming freelancers or starting their own analytics company is, how do you go about finding clients and then winning them? Okay, so I just want to make this video to sort of provide some tips on how you can go about winning clients, well, finding them first and then winning those clients. Now, if you decide to go on your own, whether you're a freelancer or whether you start your own company, or even if you do data as a side hustle, you're obviously going to need clients to get projects from. Okay. Now, one thing you'll notice is that when you work for a company, especially if you work for a consultancy or an agency that does analytics or data, data science, what you'll find is that your brand, the company you work for, especially the bigger companies, makes it easy to find clients. So when you're on your own or you're doing your own company, you know, how do you go about doing that? So in the early days, what I would suggest you do is look within your network for people who work in companies that may have need for analytics functions, okay, or have some data needs. Okay, so what you might find is that, you know, that you've got an ex-colleague, or you know someone who works in a particular company, and they may have an analytics need. So if they've got a marketing team, or if they've got a product team, or even if they've got a sales team, they'll have some analytical needs. Now, it doesn't matter if that company already has analyst, okay, because sometimes you'll find that, especially with larger organizations, they're always stretched, so they always need extra help. So the first thing I would do is, if you have your network, is reach out to them, okay. They don't have to be people in analytical roles or data roles, they can be people in any role. Just reach out to them, and what you're trying to do is get an introduction to the relevant people. Now, what you have to make sure is that when you're doing that, is that you do your research, you find out, okay, I'm going to reach out to company X, and I think that their marketing team might need some analytical support. Okay, now what you want to do is find out, is that company's already got a data team or an analytical team, and then, you know, try and work out, okay, does the analytical team do a lot of marketing analytics? If not, then maybe I can come in and help. Okay, so what you want to do is reach out to your network, your connections, and ask for introductions to people who you think might need analytical needs. Now, if your contact themselves might need it, that's brilliant, because then you've got past that first hurdle of getting an introduction. You already know the person. But generally, you'll find that they may not, so you need to keep asking them to refer you on, so that you get the right introduction and you can meet the right people to discuss what you can offer them. The next thing you might want to do is actually network with other analysts, okay? Especially people who are probably contractors or freelancers. And the reason for that is because they're going to go into lots of companies to offer their services, and they're probably usually there for a short period of time and then they leave. And what they might identify is that there is a need for analytical services that they're probably potentially not able to provide, or that if they are able to provide, there's more than they can provide. And so therefore, what you want to do is network with these other analysts, so that hopefully you can work together to help each other find opportunities. It always helps that if you find analysts where you have complementary skill rather than competing skills, because then, you know, that analyst might feel threatened if they were to introduce you, because obviously potentially you could take over their projects. So try and find data analysts or data scientists who have complementary skills to what you have, and then approach them and say, look, you know, if you come across an opportunity where I can offer XYZ which you don't offer, then please do let me know, and I'll do the same, vice versa. And hopefully that way you build a good network of co-analysts, people who you can rely on. Because what you also find is that sometimes you might win a project and you need some assistance on a skill set that you don't have. And if you've got a network of other analysts, that's brilliant. You can draw upon them and ask them to help you. Now, something I found that's really helpful when you are trying to find clients and trying to win them, especially early on, is that if you can package up some of the services that you can provide. Now, you know, if you're going with a freelancer, it's fine, because you can do a day rate and you can say, look, I can come in and my day rate is this. But sometimes when clients want to bring in freelancers or independent agencies or consultancies to do some analytical work, they sort of want to know how much it's going to cost roughly, okay? So what you want to do is you want to be able to say, package up, or you want to be able to package up the things that you can offer them. So for example, you know, if they want you to build a report in Tableau, you should have an idea of how long these things take, okay? If they want you to do a segmentation, a customer segmentation, then you should have an idea of how long these things should take, and therefore you should be able to offer a quote. Now, if you're doing freelancing, then you find that's probably not as relevant, because what happens is that freelancing is usually a day rate, and you'll go in and do that. But if you're doing analytics, you know, starting your own company analytics, or actually even if you're doing it as a side hustle, sometimes you might find that if you can package up your services, that's really good, especially in terms of a fixed price, fixed time type package. That way the client sort of gets reassurance that they'll get something in a certain amount of time and it will cost a certain amount. And then finally, what really helps is if you've got case studies. Now, you know, if you're starting off on your own, you won't have your own case study. So sometimes you can lean on things that you've done in previous roles. And the same with, say, side hustle. If you're doing side hustles, okay, you may lean on other things that you've done and demonstrate to clients what you're capable of. Because ultimately, you know, beyond the case studies, they don't really know what you're capable of. So with the case studies, you can at least say, look, we've done something similar with another organization. Yes, I appreciate it wasn't my company doing it, but I was involved in that, so I know what to do. And essentially, when you are promoting yourself as a new startup, a new data consultancy, or a freelancer, or doing it as a side hustle, you are actually promoting yourself, your skill sets, your experience, your knowledge. So case studies are great because they can demonstrate those qualities that you have. So the important thing to realize when you are trying to find clients and win them is that you need to have a good network. So therefore, before you start on the journey of whether you want to start your own data analytics consultancy or data science consultancy or be a freelancer or do it as a side hustle, is that when you're in your existing role or in your current role, try and network, okay? So try and build up your network. And the next thing is also make sure you regularly connect with that network. Now, it may not be the case that you can email everybody because you potentially won't know them that well enough to email them to keep in touch. But you can also do other ways to keep in contact with them, and that might be anything from you know, doing LinkedIn posts where you talk about things, where you have an idea and you want to share that knowledge, or even doing a blog, okay, where you would talk about certain things that you've done. And as I mentioned before, with case studies, you can use that blog as a way of demonstrating your skills, experience, and knowledge by saying, look, you know, this is a challenge I had and this is how I solved it, and you can write it as a blog, and that really then shows people what you know, what you're capable of, what skills you have, okay? So when you then go off to do your own analytics stuff as a freelancer, like I said, as your own company, or as a side hustle, you know, when you approach people, they already know something about you, so therefore it's much easier to connect with them. But again, like I said, grow your network, okay? And when you're ready to go independent, reach out to them. Just say to them, look, I'm thinking about going and doing my own thing. You know, would it be great to have a coffee, or, you know, great to have a chat or a video call, whatever's appropriate at the time, and connect with them, and then, you know, sort of explore, you know, how you could help them. So that's really my advice if you want to go about finding clients and winning them, okay, is first of all, check in your network. So obviously grow your network before you do that. And then once in your network, look for people who may be working for companies where they might have an analytical need. Try and connect with other analysts and try and, you know, create a group of people who can help each other out. Try and think about how you create packages of work. So therefore, you know, if you go in and you have to offer something, you know how long it will take and how much it will cost. That gives clients some reassurance that you have experience in these things. And then finally, try and create case studies, okay? If you can create studies, that's really great, because it then it shows the clients what your past experience, knowledge, and skills are. And then obviously the last thing that you should continue to do when you become independent is continue to stay in contact with these people, either directly or through doing, you know, blogs, posts, whatever's appropriate for you. Okay, well, thank you for listening to my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do provide any comments or questions below in the YouTube comment section below. Please do like the video, and of course, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.